No more illegal wiretapping of American citizens. No more national security letters to spy on citizens who are not suspected of a crime. No more tracking citizens who do nothing more than protest a misguided war. No more ignoring the law when it is inconvenient. That is not who
I mean, they monitor everything, absolutely everything.
Elaborate on they.
They. Well, there's lots of groups, actually, lots of initials. I mean, CIA, FBI, IMF, IMF, you name it. They. But really, they're part of the same two opposing factions.
Which are?
Which are? What? One.
Let's go in there and get them.
I call it the jar. No phone or utility lines coming in. Self-contained, unplugged from the world. Nothing for a wire bug to piggyback in on. That leaves only transmitters. It's easy enough to signal sweep for those.
Signal sweeping for transmitters. You're just a party animal.
See, the government's been in bed with the entire telecommunications industry since the 40s. They've infected everything. They get into your bank statements, your computer files, your email, listen to your phone calls.
My wife's been saying that for years.
Every wire, every airwave. The more technology you use, the easier it is for them to keep tabs on you. It's a brave new world out there.
NSA and the intelligence community in general is focused on getting intelligence wherever it can, by any means possible, that it believes on the grounds of sort of a self-certification, that they serve the national interest. Originally, we saw that focus very narrowly tailored as foreign intelligence gathered overseas. Now, increasingly, we see that it's happening domestically. And to do that, the NSA specifically, targets the communications of everyone. It ingests them by default. It collects them in its system, and it filters them, and it analyzes them, and it measures them, and it stores them for periods of time, simply because that's the easiest, most efficient, and most valuable way to achieve
some kind of
ends.
Simple encryption.
Oh, conspiracy theorists of the world unite.
Well, it's more than a theory with me. I'm a former conspirer. Yeah, I used to work for the NSA. I was a communication analyst, listened to international calls from foreign nationals.
This is the truth, this is what's happening. You should decide whether we need to be doing this.
Why should people care about surveillance?
Because even if you're not doing anything wrong, you're being watched and recorded. And the storage capability of these systems increases every year consistently by orders of magnitude to where it's getting to the point you don't have to have done anything wrong. You simply have to eventually fall under suspicion from somebody, even by a wrong call, and then they can use the system to go back in time and scrutinize every decision you've ever made, every friend you've ever discussed something with.
Watch what you say on this phone, get home fast.
We got your phone tapped, what you gonna do? Cause sooner or later, we'll have your whole crew. All we need now is the right word or two to make it all stick like glue. Dig you through, we got your phone.
My name's Ed Snowden. I'm 29 years old. I work for Booz Allen Hamilton as an infrastructure analyst for NSA in Hawaii.
Yo, it's all good. I'm hit you when I touch down tomorrow, son. Wow.
Stay on point. Don't even use the phone. Just come to my crib, yo. Word up.
The public needs to decide whether these programs and policies are right.
When it comes to telephone calls, nobody is listening to your telephone calls. That's not what this program's about. As was indicated, the intelligence community is doing is looking at phone numbers and durations of calls. They are not looking at people's names, and they're not looking at content. But by sifting through this so-called metadata, they may identify potential leads with respect to folks who might engage in terrorism.
Russia won't hand over America's most wanted man, NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden, who remains holed up in transit at a Moscow airport.
You are not to leave this building.
There's a man walking around the terminal in a bathrobe.
I think it's CIA.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Ever since Edward Snowden touched down in Moscow on Sunday, it's been the biggest mystery for the last 72 hours or so what his next move would be. He was supposed to fly to Havana from Moscow on Monday. He even checked in, supposedly, for that flight, but never made it there.
Are you headed for home?
No, I am delayed a long time.
Moscow's Sheremetyevo Airport waiting for the next move of the world's most high-profile whistleblower.
You ever feel like you're just living in an airport?